it looks a bit like the old Viva Coupe, now the Magnum. But this front's the clue. It's not quite the old familiar face. Pretty looking thing, isn't it? But that front spoiler air dam isn't there for fun. It's there to divert the airstream away from underneath the vehicle. You see, despite the fact that it looks like the ideal kind of car to do the shopping in, you know what I mean, comfy seats, room for both the kids in the back, it's not what I'd recommend as the ideal vehicle to take dear old granny out for a Sunday afternoon tootle round the country lanes. You see, what Vauxhall have done, borrowing perhaps on some of the Ford experience, is to produce a car with a dual personality, a car for use on the road, but built for the racetrack. Racing starts require strong clutch springs, and there's no doubt about it, your left foot really does ache driving this thing in heavy traffic. The gearbox, a five-speed one from the German ZF factory, obviously designed to withstand thousands of miles of performance motoring, but really mighty noisy for a road car, and very hard work too. But the hard work pays off, because the droop snoop Firenza performs like a Jaguar XJ6 in a real hurry. Up to 60 only takes 8¾ seconds, while 100 is possible inside half a minute, and they say the top speed will be getting on for 120. Off the racetrack, the ride's very firm. You feel all of the bumps all right. What you're buying is some of the rally and racetrack experience that's been logged by Vauxhall's dealer team. Racing production cars has virtually invented a new sort of sports car. A road car has been developed that handles, steers, holds the road just like a racing car. There's no lean on the turns, the steering's precise, and it has a well-balanced feel. But you have to make up your mind, I'm afraid, just what sort of driving you're going to do. Well, whatever you want to do with it, that's the way it likes being driven. A healthy boot round the test track, or better still, the circuit. But then, if you were that enthusiastic, you'd probably want to change the seats. They're comfortable enough, but they really don't hold you in as well as they might. Not for that kind of stuff, anyway. You'd also probably want a limited slip differential fitted, because right now it has a tendency to lift and spin a wheel on corners. Up here at the front end, in addition to that spoiler, they've covered over the headlamps with this sheet of glass. Aerodynamically, probably a very good idea, but there's a good deal of light scatter when you put the headlamps on. The Firenza comes fitted with the Avon safety wheel, all the way around, of course. Very good idea in the event of a puncture. Under there, the power unit, 2300 cc's, the Vauxhall inline 4, with two big Stromberg carburetors, and the whole thing produces 130 brake horsepower. And finally, the price, £2,625. Now, that's £850 more than the Magnum. But then again, you couldn't do it yourself for that price. Final verdict on the Firenza, then? It's a lot of fun. But like so many fun things, it's an acquired taste.